Welcome to everybody. Today we'll be talking about the class Phaeophysi. That is a class of comes under algology, which will be dealing with brown algae. So this class Phaeophysi comprises of over 250 genera and 1500 species, and it is mainly found in warmer regions of around 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. The species are mainly marine in nature, but Pleurocladia, Bardonella and Herbandiella are found in fresh waters of European countries. The pigments present in this class of algae are xanthophyll, fucoxanthin in the chromatophores, and also chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B are also found, but predominantly xanthophyll and fucoxanthin are found. The color of the Phaeophysi members varies from olive green to dark brown. Reserve food materials is laminarin and mannitol. Mannitol is very biologically significant for human beings. And if you consider the water ecosystem, that is the aquatic ecosystem, these Phaeophysi members can be found in the littoral region. Spacellaria can be found in upper littoral region. Letitia can be found in mid littoral region, and members of laminarias can be found in lower littoral region. And lithophytes, mainly except sargassum, all the Phaeophysi members are lithophytes. So the classification, in 1945, Fisk classified the members of Phaeophysi into 9 orders. That is, the first one, Ectocarpales; second one is the Telopteridales; third one is the Cutlariales; fourth one is the Sporocnales; fifth one is the Desmerostiales; sixth one is the Laminariales; seventh one is the Spacellariales; eighth one is the Dictyotales; and ninth one is the Fucales. In this classification, the least primitive is the Fucales and the most primitive is Ectocarpales. So coming to the thallus structure of the members of Phaeophysi, these Phaeophysi members are highly evolved and they resemble a miniature angiospermic plants. So when compared to the members of Chlorophysi and the members of Phaeophysi, these are highly evolved and are close to, evolutionarily if you see, the Phaeophysi members are close to that of the angiosperm plants. And in the lower forms of Ectocarpales, you can also see heterotrichism. Heterotrichism in the sense, if you consider the types of the Phaeophysi members, once few of the types will be growing vertically to the region where it is attached, and some of them will be growing very horizontal to the substratum which is attached. Ectocarpales, the members of Ectocarpales exhibit heterotrichism, and as the order, as the class evolves, this heterotrichism is only seen in or restricted to gametophytic generations. And in also complexity in the vegetative structure, or the may it be vegetative or anatomical or physiological, the Ectocarpales are least evolved, and the Fucales, as the order increases from Ectocarpales to the Fucales, the complexity in the vegetative structure, anatomical and also physiological structure increases. And many of the Phaeophysi members have lower cylindrical portion, that is called as the stipe. If you compare it to an angiospermic plant, you can tell it as a stem of the plant. Here, in Phaeophysi, the lower cylindrical structure is called as type of the thallus. And this type of the thallus is attached to the substratum to a tuft of root-like structures or hair-like structures called as rhizoids, which are mainly parenchymatous in nature. And the stipe, the cylindrical stipe, extends further upwards and are highly differentiated into irregular structures called fronds. Now, mainly these are Phaeophysi members are very large in nature and they can grow up to feet of height. And some of the species like Macrocystis, they can grow up to 200 to 600 feet of height, which mainly concludes that why they are found in marine regions. Coming to the internal morphology of the Phaeophysi members, if you come to the lower orders, that is the Ectocarpales, for example Dictyota, which comes under Ectocarpales, there are three regions found in this Dictyota. So the uppermost region and the lower region, that is the upper peripheral cells and the lower peripheral cells, are mainly like the outer coverings of this dictyotales. And in the middle of the region, middle of the thallus, you can find the fucosan vesicles and reserve food materials, which is called as middle larger cells because they are comparatively larger in size. And as the class evolve, in case of fucales and laminariales, you can differentiate the cortex or the inner thallus into three regions, that is the outer epidermis, middle cortex and the inner cortex. So the outer epidermal region is mainly meristematic in nature and is cuticular in nature, so as to protect it from the water. And this outer epidermis is a little bit columnar and is convex in the outer side, and since it is meristematic, divides throughout its life, it is called as meristematic zone or meristematic layer. And the inner cortex, the middle cortex of the phaeophysi members, is involved in storage and other various functions. So, and the middle medullary region is mainly associated with the conduction of the food materials, and they are highly lignified and thick walled cells in the medullary region. Medulla also consists of cross connections and perforated walls so as to conduct the food to the different regions of the plant body. Now coming to the cell structure, individual cell structure. The cell wall of the cells of phaeophysi are made up of two layers. The outer layer is made up of cellulose and arranged in the form of parallel microfibrils. The outer region is gelatinous and composed of pectic substances or algin or fucoidin, which is colloidal in nature and is of very importance. So this was all about the class phaeophysi for today in this module. The remaining aspects of this class will be discussed in the further modules. Thank you.